So here's a couple of things to keep in mind. It's much easier to put in a manifold system that is pre-built, and it doesn't cost very much extra. You don't need to put in unions at both ends of the valves. Here are the valves. We have three valves, that's three zones. There's unions on top of them. You don't have to put unions going to the distribution lines. It is a very good idea to put in a gauge so that you can tell what the pressure is. Here we have put a gauge that's connected with a union and an elbow and a bunch of other connectors. This is easily replaced by taking that union off and putting on a cap. And here's a cap that goes right there instead of the union. What we've done is put in a shut off. It is not critically important to do so, but it's nice to have an outside shut off. And that's this thing right here. It is very important to have a way to blow out your system. We put that in with another shut off right here. And this is the connection, quick connect for a blowout for the system. When you're not using it, you turn that off, and as it is positioned right now, and when you are using it, you turn it on by just flipping that ball valve. And this is the ball valve that shuts off the entire system as well. I like to use the zone valves that are that allow manual override. These ones allow manual override, and you just turn them this way and they turn on without the timer. It's much easier to test this way. These particular valves also allow for flow control, so these are very nice valves, usually not available at Home Depot, and you can get the ones that are at Home Depot and Lawn Genie ones, but I like these best. So that's the preview there. We did not put in a vacuum breaker outside. Those vacuum breakers break really quickly. When you have a quick freeze overnight in the spring or in the fall, instead what we're gonna do is put an RPZ valve inside the house, and I'll show you one of those.